Hello, Wobblies. Welcome to Wobbly Otter Outdoors. I'm Chris, and in this episode, we are making and using natural fiber rope tinder tubes. Many years ago, we got a couple of pump pressure sprayers to treat our oak trees for oak wilt, and we didn't need the brass nozzles. So we've had them for all these years, and being the ingenious person that he is, Bill cut one of them to make a tube for a rope tinder fire starter. Bill cut the tube to a 5-inch length only because that's the width of the vise he used to hold it when he cut it. We're going to try out 3 tinder tubes. One is made by Uberleben. It is a hemp rope through a anodized aluminum sleeve, and the rope has paraffin wax on it. Two is a cotton rope that we are going to soak in paraffin, and we're using the brass tube from the sprayer nozzle. And three, we're going to make a braided rope out of jute twine. Then we're going to soak that in paraffin wax as well. So the way the tinder tube works is you feed the rope through the tube and then you light the rope, and you can use that as sort of a match or a little torch to light whatever you need to light, because it will continue burning longer. And then when you're through using it, you can pull the rope back into the tube to snuff out the flame. So let's look at what we've got so far, and we will make a tinder tube using this brass spray nozzle. On your left are the two ropes that were made with the paraffin wax, or infused with the paraffin wax. And then on your right are the two ropes that were infused with the beeswax. We'll see if there's any difference. Let's try using the jute rope that's been in the paraffin wax first to make our little tinder tube. Maybe instead of a 3-strand braid, I should have done a 2-strand twist. Since I'm having too much difficulty getting the 3-strand through, I'm going to change it to a 2-strand rope. So I'm going to try to unbraid this real quick and then use just 2 of the strands of twine. I'm going to have little white paraffin wax flakes everywhere. Let's pick 2 fairly smooth ones, and we will braid those. Twist. Oh, much easier. That's actually threadable. So first we're going to light them with a flame. One thing about a wax-coated fire starter is it is somewhat waterproof. So then this you would use as your match to light your fire, and because it continues to burn, that gives you plenty of time. And then when you're ready to put the fire out, you slide the tinder tube up and it snuffs the flame. So it's burning much faster. We've got a pretty good breeze. And at least it's not blowing out. So it still has enough wax. It's burning for a little bit. Even though we had to unbraid and then rebraid the strands, they still seem to have enough wax on them that it's burning for a pretty good time. And then to snuff it out, pull it down in the tube. Rope is very hard. Okay, it just fits. Yay! And it slid through without any trouble. Let's see if we can fray the end so it will catch. And it caught really well. This is awesome. Okay, I really, really like the cotton rope. The cotton rope is working much, much better. Nice flame, big flame, long burning flame. Of course, we didn't have to take this apart and put it back together, so that kind of makes a difference. And poof. Okay, so let's compare these two ropes. On your right is the cotton rope that we soaked in paraffin wax, and on your left is the store-bought hemp rope fire starter that we got, also infused with paraffin wax. When feeling the two, though, hemp rope is definitely softer than the one that we made. The one that we made has a hard crust on it, and it's not as flexible and soft. The fibers on the tops feel very similar after they've been scraped with the knife. They both still feel coated with wax, yet they're obviously a little bit fluffy and a little bit soft. Let's go see if we can get them to take a spark. Let's try the store-bought one, the Uberleben hemp rope. Oh, it started right up. Okay. Ooh. The Uberleben rope started right up. This is the hemp rope with it. Why is it still sparking? This is the hemp rope with the paraffin wax infused into it. It did catch. Took a little more work, but it did catch. And it burns with a fury. Let's try the jute. So I think if I'd made a better braid of the jute rope, it would work better. It took a spark fairly well. It's burning okay. The cotton rope seems to work better. I wonder if that's pieces of the fero rod that are catching and popping like that. This is a pitiful excuse for a rope. This is a closer view of the Uberleben Tinder tube. The tube is anodized aluminum. It's about 3 inches long. And they say you can use it as a micro bellows, but it's awful short for a bellows. This is the Tinder tube that Bill made. It's about 5 inches long. It's brass. I didn't notice a great difference in the heat that was transferred down to where your fingers were holding it. Both seem to work equally well. If you do want to use it as a micro bellows, that extra couple of inches might be beneficial. This is the cotton rope with beeswax. Let's see if I can get it to light. Okay, took a light. It's burning pretty well. Let's see if we can get it to take a spark. Beeswax is incredibly sticky. When scraping the paraffin wax earlier, on both the hemp rope as well as the jute rope, the fibers separated and would get even actually a little fluffy. This is what it looks like after doing the exact same process on the cotton rope soaked with beeswax. It is not fluffy at all. It is a sticky glob. So to summarize what we've seen, it appears that the Uberleben hemp rope paraffin wax infused works really, really well. The fibers are easy to expose. It catches a flame the best of the things that we tested. The hemp rope is nice and dense and burns easily. And the aluminum sleeve works really well. For the tinder tubes that we made, the tube itself is fantastic. The 5-inch brass tube seemed to work great. Of the two paraffin wax coated tinder ropes that we made, the jute took a spark much more easily than the rope did. It's probably because the paraffin wax so much has come off of the jute with all the working that we did on it. And also the cotton rope burned much brighter and longer, made a heck of a torch when compared to the jute. When comparing beeswax to paraffin wax in the use of a tinder rope tinder tube, I cannot recommend beeswax. We did it just as an experiment to see what, if any, difference it would make. It makes a big difference. The beeswax is so sticky that you cannot expose the natural fibers, so it's hard to get them to light with a flame, much less with spark. I could not get it to light with spark. So there's some things that we've tried out and learned. And we'll probably do a little differently in the future. I don't know what that would be, though. We're happy with the results and that what we tried did work. And we're really impressed with the ease of how the Uberleben does work. We'll put product links down in the description. And in the comments, let us know what you think. And if you've ever tried these tinder tubes and what your experience was. Thanks for watching, Wobbly Otter. We love you and hope all your tomorrows are bright and hope you're healthy and safe. Until next time. So the way the tinder tube works is you feed the rope through the tube. So the idea with the, you're helping me again.